to welcome the heroes of the Commonwealth Games Delhi 2010.
Cool News reports say it's considered a difficult runway to land on. This is the face of India's anti-corruption movement. The man who's inspiring these people is 74-year-old Anna Hazare.
Victory even more remarkable because it was a single-handed one.
Dhoni finishes off in style. A magnificent strike into the crowd. India lift the World Cup after 28 years.
India has successfully test-fired its indigenously developed intercontinental or surface-to-surface nuclear-capable ballistic missile Agni 5.
The cremation of Shiv Sena Supremo Bal Thackeray will be held today at Shivaji Park in central Mumbai.
One thing to convey to the government, you hit 10 people, will come 10,000. We are not going to stop no matter what, whatever you do.
Arvind Kejriwal's Aam Aadmi Party has formally been launched today.
India telling the world it can go all the way to Mars.
You may increase the cost, but please do not discontinue the telegram services.
Common people coming out to help each other, but slowly now the attempts to try and bring back life to a normalcy is also taking place.
What a wonderful. And it all started from the age of 11 when he took me to Achrekar sir, my coach, and from there all my life changed.
It is a historic day today as Aam Aadmi Party leader Arvind Kejriwal is set to be sworn in as the 7th Chief Minister of Delhi.
We can say for the last 1 year, we haven't had even a single case of polio.
Narendra Modi will be India's next Prime Minister.
Anna Naival has become the first Indian badminton player to reach the world number one spot.
With the death toll having already crossed 1800 and there are fears it could keep rising further.
Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal declaring day one of the odd-even trial in the capital a success.
Here in Tamil Nadu, she has created history because for the first time in 3 decades, an incumbent government is coming back to power.
All voice calls for Jio customers will be absolutely free.
This is an extremely difficult time for people in the state. Deeply emotional at the news of the loss of their beloved leader.
Donald Trump called this, he predicted an election night shocker, and he was 100% right.
500 and 1,000 rupees notes will not be legal tender from midnight.
Bench has ruled out triple talaq. The bench has held that triple talaq is invalid. It is invalid as per the constitution, it is invalid as per the Quran.
Unidentified men shot her 7 times from close range and 3 bullets hit her. Lankesh has been shot dead at her home in Bengaluru.
22 people have been killed in a stampede that broke out on a narrow footover bridge near a local train station in Mumbai.
Flying officer Avni Chaturvedi has made history by becoming the first Indian woman to fly a fighter aircraft solo.
Justice Deepak Mishra is reading out. This one says homosexuality is not an offence. Says the verdict.
Feel ho raha hai ki hum udne lage ab.
Azadi.
Prime Minister Modi is now unveiling the Statue of Unity.
He rose above politics. He rose above ideology, idealism.
People are walking miles to safety through what officials say are the worst floods for a century.
I think everyone needs to understand that there is an emotional cost to being harassed sexually.
A big story today is coming, as I said, from Pulwama, where a major victory for the forces, but at a heavy cost. But the story of the day is Prime Minister Narendra Modi storming back to power with an even bigger mandate than he had in 2014.
My identity, that I am a Kashmiri, my Kashmiriyat, that has been ruined, that has been murdered in the parliament.
Today marks the end of one of India's most controversial and deadliest religious disputes.
We're gathered here today, students from various universities, because it is our right, it is our constitutional right, it is our fundamental right to protest what's happening in the country. It goes against the very idea of what India is supposed to be, which is a secular country, which has always been a home for people of different faiths and beliefs.